I think it should be priority of every growth stage entrepreneur that you need to optimize your entire operations, because that is where you say you can save a lot of money as well. If you have operations which are streamlined, they'll be less chaos, you'll be saving a lot of man-hours, you'll be saving a lot of money, directly or indirectly, both. So I would strongly recommend optimizing operations. We use a lot of tools to optimize operations. For example, to optimize communication in the team, we use Slack as a platform, right? It's a free tool for certain people, and then it's a paid version. For communicating with clients, we use G Suite. So I think G Suite again gives you a lot of things so that through which you can collaborate. Like they give you access to Drive, calendar, Google Hangout. You can talk to people, cross communicate. That's a fantastic tool. For project management, you can use Asana, Basecamp, Trello. So these are a lot of tools which can help you, segregate your work into small buckets and help you optimize your entire operations. Another bigger problem that I see in terms of, wherein entrepreneurs can use tools to optimize things is I see finance and accounts as a sector, because the problem with finance and accounts is that a lot of startups and guys are tech entrepreneurs or are building company into tech space. The problem in that particular space is that they don't understand finance. They are not finance professionals. So using tools like Zoho for accounting, invoicing, will help you and save a lot of time. So you can automate your entire invoicing process, quotation sending process, accounting process, and ultimately your balance sheet creation process. So your entire finance is sorted if you use third-party tools like that. So I would strongly recommend that you can look into all of SaaS-based tools. There are so many out there. And in fact, I consult a lot of startups. But I think primary requirement number one before moving on to tools is that you need to lay down the process first. And I believe as a growth stage startup or a growth stage entrepreneur, you have already done that. So once your process is in place, is on the papers, is in the book, it's frozen, then you can look into tools, plug and play, chip in those tools wherever required, and your life will be very sorted. In terms of impact in a startup, that why do you need to use tools? I think number one, if you're using all these tools, which are primarily SaaS-based tools, and if you've laid down the process, the biggest advantage is going to be you will be able to optimize a lot of things. So it's going to save you a lot of direct and indirect cost. Number two is transparency. When you're using all these tools, you have a very clear-cut picture as in what is happening in the organization. So you don't have to waste a lot of time. And number three, and a very important thing, is analytics. So you see all the data in the real time. So once you have very clear-cut analytics, I think you know which direction your company is going in. As a growth stage entrepreneur, I think transparency, analytics, and saving the cost, I think these are very critical and very important factors for you to incorporate.